Hello and welcome to Kentucky American Water's Lexington Farmers Market Report. Joining us from the Lexington Farmers Market, Josh England. Josh, welcome back to WKY. What's happening over there at the Lexington Farmers Market?
We're here to talk about peppers of all varieties. Yummy peppers and mild bell peppers, all the way up to scorpion peppers and Carolina Reapers, and the ones that will burn your face off if you're not careful, the kind that you have to sign a waiver for if you get a sauce made out of it at a wing joint. Can be confusing sometimes because we just have one word and then there's people say chili peppers or sweet peppers and then there are the colors, and so it can be a little overwhelming if you're not used to all the different varieties. You might have your bell peppers, which are in underripe, medium ripe, and fully ripe, which means green, yellow, orange, and bright red. And then you go all the way to maybe having a couple of poblanos, which is a milder hot pepper, to jalapeno or serrano. Get to the farmer's market and you have all of those choices plus tenfold more, and it can be a little bit complicated, but I'll tell you a little trick. If it's a huge pepper, it's usually milder, and the smaller the pepper, the hotter. Much like a scorpion sting, the more dangerous the scorpion is, the smaller its pincers are. The same with peppers. You get that bite from the very, very tiny ones typically. The chemical is called capsaicin. It is a defense mechanism. It is predominantly in the seeds and then the internal support structure, so those little veins and things like that. Something like a Carolina Reaper 2, which has over 2 million Scoville units. It means 2 million drops of milk before you can neutralize one drop of the taste of the hotness from that pepper. It spreads, and so you just need a little bit of something like that. A jalapeno or a banana pepper, they're much lower in the 50 to 100,000 Scoville units, and so they're much more manageable, and you can avoid some of those really hot internal structures that have that concentration. I love really hot things when I'm cooking, but if I was just going to make something that's really highlighting the great flavors of a pepper, I'm going to go with a spicy banana pepper, batter it with a nice tempura style batter, and then just enjoy it that way. I think that tempura spicy peppers are delicious. They highlight all the best parts. They're really easy, and so you can't go wrong there.
Josh, thank you so much for coming in and telling us about peppers and the Lexington Farmers Market.
Thanks for having me.
And thank you for joining us for the Lexington Farmers Market Report, brought to you by Kentucky American Water. And we'll see you down there at the Lexington Farmers Market, where friends meet. I'm Joe Conkright for WUKY. The move to come up with the hotter pepper is amazing. Within the last, say, 20 years, people are always trying to develop that next level hotness, and it just keeps going up and up, crossbreeding different types to try to get that really high Scoville.
Yeah, we're getting to the point, though, where you have to be crazy to even want to grow them, because just being in the same room with some of the peppers as you're drying them in order to get the seeds, in order to plant to make the cross-pollination and all of that, it's getting dangerous. And so you'll see people who specialize in the super hot peppers, they'll wear respirators and basically a hazmat suit. And the use for those peppers is very limited. If you're making a pot of chili in a giant burgoo cauldron, then maybe you can use one or two of those peppers to make your whole soup five alarm. For the most part, normal people, sane people, don't need things that hot.
Well, let's talk about some sane uses for some of the peppers. And of course, bell peppers are great for stuffing. Do you have any secret stuffing methods for your peppers?
I would say that people can get very intimidated with knowing how to use a sweet pepper, a bell pepper, a yummy pepper, and stuff them. The key to that is getting a kitchen thermometer, and that will really alleviate so much of your worry about cooking peppers, because the number one thing is, if you're using ground meat, the internal temperature of the ground meat inside the pepper with all the flavorings and juices to the safe temperature. But once you have a little meat thermometer, you can just poke in there. It takes away a lot of the guessing game. And it allows you to incorporate more ingredients that will add flavor and moisture. I think that's one thing that people are afraid of when they are stuffing the pepper, is they want it to have the same texture when they put it in the oven as when they get it out. And it has to be more juicy, more moist when you put it in, because it's going to evaporate and lose some of that moisture as it cooks. One really fun way to use especially really good, sweet, ripe red bell peppers is to blend it up and make it into a pasta. I know that sounds weird, but instead of using water, You use the pureed red bell pepper as the liquid for making the pasta, and it makes it really bright and red, and it turns out really great. If you don't want to do that on your own, we have local pasta makers across the state, or in Lexington, Lexington Pasta, that does use local fresh ingredients in order to make their seasonal pasta. And so that will save you some work if you don't want to do that extra step of blanching, peeling, pureeing, and then making the pasta from scratch.
I guess we should also mention that there are pre-prepared hot sauces with local ingredients available at the farmer's market.
Yeah, there are two different ways you can make hot pepper sauces. One is a sort of pickle ferment, and then there's the lacto-fermented. And we have both kinds of hot sauces available using local ingredients. You get more of a bright, vinegary, acidic taste with some of the fresh prepared hot sauces that are then bottled. You get a more funky, vibrant, wider flavor palette with some of the long fermented pepper sauces. You can buy those at the market, or you can buy some of the hot peppers that you pick up at the farmer's market to bump up the heat a little bit.
One thing I really like about peppers, especially bell peppers, they're so versatile. You can grill them, you can bake them, you can eat them raw with dip or something like that. It's a very versatile vegetable.
It's very forgiving too. So you can really barely overcook them and they still taste good. You can undercook them and they still taste good. You can almost burn them on the grill and you just peel off the outside layer and you have this beautiful charred, roasty, toasty flavor. Peppers, especially the bell peppers or the sweet peppers, they are so forgiving. If you're looking for a way to get into using and incorporating more local produce, but you're looking at the prices and you're thinking, oh, this is expensive. In season, peppers are one thing that is much more affordable from a farmer's market than at a grocery store. You can eat them immediately, or they preserve really well. You can either dry them, you can freeze them, you can make them into a sauce, and they're just really forgiving and taste really good.